Rewarding and undoubtedly challenging session. If elected majority leader, I look and ready to deal with whatever may come your way, with help of those around you, and adjust your plan accordingly. There is no doubt sometimes you don't always get along on the trip, and there might be some disagreements about which direction to go, especially when the month of a rock lies ahead, and there's going to be some rocks. The key is a guide is to listen to all points of view, be able to provide clear direction as the best path forward. And no matter what, a trip is always much more fun and successful if everybody works together. I've been reminded of these leadership principles as I learned in my early days of guiding as I served in leadership in Maine legislation. This is why I've been committed to a leadership style that values open lines of communication, consensus building, and dialogue. My hope would be to develop a culture in the Maine Democratic caucus that seeks input from all members. Welcomes reason dissent and respects differences of opinion. But beyond just our caucus, I am also committed to working with our Republican colleagues in the House and in the Senate, and I'm willing to work with Governor Page. It is essential for us as elected officials to move beyond the party labels and work together to build a better future for the people of this great state. I've been reflecting a lot over the last week and last week's election, thinking over and over again, not getting much sleep. One of my major takeaways is that the voters of Maine have spoken. They want us to work together. They want us to move past the pettiness, the politics, the bickering, the foolishness that has come to characterize local, state, and national politics. Maine people are tired of the gridlock, and they're tired of the one-upsmanship between the parties. People of Maine have selected a Republican governor, a Republican senator, an independent senator, congressional representatives from each party, a Republican Senate, and a Democratic House. They don't care about party labels or partisan ideologies. They care about government that works. They want a government they can be proud of. They want a government that can come together and find common ground. It's time that we give them the government that they ask for. I believe that I have the right mix of experience, leadership skills, relationships, attitude, and temperament to help lead our caucus and lead this state forward. Because with the right leadership, we can find common ground and craft strong and promising compromises while at the same time standing up for our values and know what it takes to move Maine forward. There is no doubt we're not always going to get along or agree with our friends across the aisle, or maybe even not get along in our own caucus. That's fine. In fact, disagreeing is healthy, and it should be embraced, because we all came to the State House with different perspectives, backgrounds, and experience. I want you all to know the Speaker and I do not always agree, and actually don't agree a lot. And from time to time, we have to work on our different views, our perspectives, and that leads to a stronger caucus. From my time as the lead Democrat on the Agriculture Conservation Forestry Committee to serving as the assistant leader, I have been so proud of my experience working to bring people together from different perspectives and different backgrounds, engaging in healthy dialogue so that we can find common ground and compromise. Throughout my 6 years in the legislature, I have a proven track record of being able to negotiate with Democrats and with Republicans. I met with House Republican Leader Ken Fredette and Senate President Thibodeau last week about continuing to work together. The relationships I have built with the Republicans over the last 6 years will be vital, an important asset for our efforts in the coming years. I also reached out to the governor and his staff last week, writing a handwritten note suggesting that we sit down and we meet in a casual manner, and offering to meet on any terms that they propose. Over the last 2 years, Steve Reeves and I have worked well together. But we have not always been in lockstep with one another. I have pushed him, and we have negotiated how to move forward on certain issues. I have helped him listen and hear the voices of the members of our caucus who don't always see eye to eye. years in the legislature, and as the assistant majority leader, I am proud of the relationships I have developed with you and the relationships I have developed across the aisle. I am ready to continue doing that as a majority leader, and hope that I can count on your support today. I am honored by the support that many of you have already pledged, from Southern Maine, from Northern Maine, from Rural Maine, Urban Maine. Many of you have expressed your support. Many of you have earned your support over the last week, meeting with you, having one-on-one conversations, and discussing our plan as we move forward. And to those of you who are still undecided today, I sincerely ask for your vote. It's been a very humbling experience sitting in the corner, listening to speeches. Again, I really want to thank my friend Joan, my friend Bob. It's quite humbling to hear such kind words. I look forward to working with each and every one of you in the coming months and ahead, and I promise to listen, I promise to lead, and I promise that we can be proud. Thank you very much.